Today I'm going to talk a little about the genealogy again. A little more clearance with my brain on it. I did when I made this particular chart, where it perhaps wasn't clear that you have to go back to the 8th generation and in the writing of just put in if you don't know the line of where it's from, if it's a French or if it's the English, you just put in the wife and follow what you presume would have been the husband and wife. If you know the husband is already the English, chances are there would be another English. If there was a French, chances are another French. So if that would be the, but yeah, it has to go all the way to the 8th to get the 50% on either side of the parents there. So that helps the program have its, and that's the only way I could have done it. That's the only way there was no way to just start it from the 6th generation and have a purity of the exact at that moment, because it's a constant feed in all the time, and from the others, one generation up. So I had to have a consumption entry area, and that was the 8th generation. So that goes with there. But right now I am talking of DNA. DNA into your person, into your bloodline. Now here I have listed because there are many points missing. I don't know if this was the closest. I don't know if this was the closest. There could have been a closer one, but I have a 10th generation Drake. Now, so that's what's exciting for a moment. You know, I'm like, okay, great, a 10th generation Drake. So I look it up, and there's about 512 persons involved, surnames, great, that are part of my DNA at that point. 512 of them, lines. And that means he is a 0.2, or she, 0.2% of my blood. So 0.20 of my blood is Drake, D-R-A-K-E. So in there, I'm thinking, my goodness, I do have an affinity for boats, and I have looked at boats many times in my life, and the Drake family itself was a traveler of the boats. They went back and forth across the Atlantic Ocean like crazy, and that was it, you know, they were just back and forth. They were running practically their own line, and then the one who did the travels of the circumnavigations and the mapping, the consumption into the mapping. So they were all involved in the travel. And it's an interest how like over-consumed I found myself, almost OCD fashion, having access to this internet and going to those websites that have the boats. And I'm like, why am I here all the time looking at these boats? I have to look at every single type of hull. I have to know every single type of inside, every single type of outside, every single type of sail. I'm just it's almost like a movie event for me. Like it becomes an entertainment. Like I had no idea this was available. So it's an odd fascination. And so I do find it really easy to jump and say that 0.20 event within my DNA would be a personality direction almost of enjoyment factor that I would be entertained by, that I would really need to be curious in. And then you can go back. You can always go back and say, well, my father was a painter, and his father was a painter, and the other one was a painter. Even if they never even knew each other or met each other, they find out later on they were painters of painters of painters, and that's the way it goes. And so that becomes interesting. So even with the 0.20%, I find myself absolutely encapsulated within geography, with geography, heavy. I'm heavy on geography, and I'm very heavy on boats. Very interesting. So 0.20, and then I start to think, oh my gosh, blood percentage. Does that affect me physically? Is there something in the 0.20? If that particular line at that time, if they're carrying something, does that affect me physically? Is that something that is replicated now in my blood? Is that something that can be a multiplier? Is there a multiplier? And often we are looking at the disease itself, if they're carrying something in that point in the line. Can that be multiplied from the 0.2%? I know it's a very small amount, but I am very curious in how often I have looked at maps of the world and just been completely fascinated all the way back to the flooding of the Garden of Eden, those maps. I'm consumed by that energy, and wondering how the flows and the rivers and all of this goes on, and it's just an odd curiosity. And sometimes I'm like, why would I be curious in this? You know, it's just a stupid thing. And it has no relevance to life now. Why would I need it? You know, it's almost like a past. It's almost like a past. Entertainer. It's entertained. It's almost like an entertainment genre of curiosity there. So, and then I look into the Drake, and then I'm like, not happy with him at all. Not happy with him, and perhaps I'm like, no. I'm for sure not that one. Not the one who circumnavigated. I will only from the brother line. You know, only his brother. And so that's better. You know, when you're only from the brother, it's much better, because the one was the one who did take the natives, the tribes directly, the very first, who took them back to England, as show and tell. Look what I found on the islands. Very first ones dragging them in as slaves. That's not really something fun to keep, is it? That's not something to keep. But even as a brother line, direct off that, I am equivocated into, aren't I? I'm equivocated into that. Because gee whiz, you know, how much all of them would have done it, you know, at that point. And why were they allowed to be the pirates that went around the world and stole for the queen or the king of the time? That was just the way it was. That they were legal pirates. And why they went through Spain and torched it. Those marinas and those boats, they thieved. And those riches, they planked out. So how come that wasn't available for not being called a pirate? And yet they were still pirate actions, military events of thieving on behalf of Britain. So they were doing this. So at this point, two of my line was quite content to receive that dominative adulation from the monarchy as a yes, that's the way it's done. You thieve for us around the world, and you bring items, even persons. And at that time, those persons were of the native tribes. So it started slavery. We can say it started slavery, or a curiosity into slavery, the bringing of them. So who's to blame? Who's to blame? Is it the monarchy itself, you know? Bring me things. Is it the monarchy itself? I must be entertained. Show me the world items. Bring me those resources. Gather them on your ships, and I'll give you more. Bring back ships from others, and you will have wealth. So yeah, what was the reason? What was the purpose? What was the reason and what was the purpose? And I'm just, oh, jerks, jerks, jerks. Right, so I have this. And then the fights within are absolutely tremendous, aren't they? When I have the fights of the Catholicism on the one side, and I have the fights over here, heavy Catholicism. Oh my goodness. And then the heavy fights against all other kinds, I will just say all other kinds of religions. Right here within my body, fighting, you know, it's like they, you know, that DNA was so strong for so many years in their line, and that was it, There is no way, we are ever getting out of it. You know, year after year after year after year, you know, that is bloodline thick of one religion in one surname. Again and again and again and again. So there is a sturdy duration there of fight to the death and warring. And some were. And so I look here at this the clashing that goes on. When you have let's say you are 25% German and you are 25% French, and you are 25% Spanish, and you are 25% English, and you're like, oh my goodness, that's just the fight of the fight, isn't it? The fight of the fight group, you know, enemies, major enemies within me. So that's a tough one, isn't it? It's a tough one to carry, having four major enemies that have all wanted to kill each other, have killed each other, beheaded each other, guillotined each other. Oh yeah, and then I found out a little bit of Italian possible, you know, and even Jew. You know, that's an extra fun. And now they're fighting over that. You know, even online, they're fighting over the Judea even existing in a name. It's like, what? It's like, if it's in there, it's in there. Just give it up. Big deal. My gosh, you Catholics can really be constrainant on your person, can't you? For such a, like, you know, here I am, you know, I'm thinking, oh, great, I've got this 25-30%, you know, Catholic thick. Then I got the French there, and they're 25-30% Catholic thick, of some sort of Christian thick, I'll call them. And then the English Christian thick, they're all Christian thick. Gosh dang it, it's a heavy cross, isn't it? It's a heavy cross. Just dragging around in that soil. And then the whole time I just think, you all got it wrong. You just didn't read it. You just didn't read it right. The dude, Jesus wasn't even looking for anything like that. It's just about enlightenment, you know? It's just about enlightenment. And then the Mormons, oh my. Gosh, are you kidding me? One guy has 30 children, you know? One guy has 30 children. And from those children, how many others? Many of them die first. His first, you know, children, grandchildren, they didn't survive. But after that, oh my gosh, how many did they make? Drug companies have been born and spawned from that group. You know, how much do I hate being associated even with having a great-great-grandfather of that lineage? I am the world, it seems so. I am the Western world, in many respects. That corporation. Well, yeah, and I wanted to get into it, but into the chemical of oxygen, the amount of nitrogen oxygen. It looks like argon, 0.93 is argon percent. So, in even breathing, the Drake line, that would be the 0.2. So it's not, it doesn't encapsulate with argon, A-R-G-O-N. No, it's not that close. I would have to go back a little closer into the eighth generation to get closer to the argon effect. But yeah, interesting. And you find out all kinds of stupidities, you know, nitrous oxide, even being the oxygen and the nitrogen mix only, you know, not nitrogen, forget it, I'm not a chemist. It must not be in my line, you know. And so there I am, thinking about all of these things. And yet, yeah, over fascination with the boats, getting on those boats and traveling, and not stopping, just being a continuant there. Yeah, and plans and travels to even cross the Atlantic. Two people to cross the Atlantic in a boat, and the boat wasn't even ready, and it's like I didn't have the equipage in my mind. I just knew I needed the boat, and the hull wasn't prepared properly, and it's just like, what an idiot. And I guess I just can't rely on the 0.2% of fascination value. I would have actually had to learn a little more. So darn it, the 0.2 of fascination want value does not actually bring you the actual truth of being able to have it all, you know, just straight across with a sextant. It doesn't work like that. I don't know, maybe the boat was built improperly. Maybe the boat was built improperly, but that was the only one at the time we could have purchased, you know what I mean? Only one at the time. And maybe it would have been a fool's journey to people anyway. Yeah, maybe. I mean, we're talking bigger boats, captaining them. You're talking bigger boats, you know. None of this little tiny. Yeah. The wars within. Quite fascinating. And now they're fighting over this one name, Enriquez. They're going to fight over Enriquez being a Jew. They're going to fight, even though it's listed there in the something major. And then they're going to just claim the Enriquez are Spanish. You know, they're Spanish. They're Spanish, everyone. Christian Spanish, that's the way to go. And then you're crossed into the saint line, and you can just keep going up that mountain and bludgeoning your knees with, you know. And so I start thinking, are these my little DNA personalities on the inside, you know, the little martyrism that lives within me? I have to go through that. I mean, it's just like never ending. How do I remove myself from that martyrization? If that has been a personality, actual learned state again and again and again, that this is the only way, you know. Go up to that cross, everyone. Yeah. Well, anyway, it's an absolute wonderful quest to start into, and it's great to have one line that has supplied me with so much data. But you can always just take that one name. You have that one name. You can take that name and study it quite indulgently. If you have several names, you can study them indulgently. The more names you have, you start definitely looking at your blood type and your personality, and that that does become a wonder, doesn't it? We have health, and we have personality, we have our interests. What are our interests? What are our goals? How far do we succeed? How far do we not succeed? How heavy are we into being religious zealots? How many preachers and pastors do I have in my line? You know, oh my goodness, I think I'm canonized somewhere along the way in Denmark. Awful, awful, awful. Is the dude still there, you know? What do? You know, put all those guys, you know, in a pile. It's just awful. I apologize for that domination of historical town to town, you know, a canonized some kind of a dude. I don't know, even know what it meant. He was a pope of some sort at the time. You know, I don't know, not the full-on pope, but somebody close to the pope. But so close that you're like, no, he's there still? Is that what it means? He's there inside a tank? I don't know. It's just a horrible event. Anything to do with religion and those crosses being dragged around from a little teensy change in the book, you know, a little teensy change in the right, you know, these plates, and this one over here has this book, and this is Calvinism, and over there, oh my gosh, are Huguenots, and over there, that's a guillotine, you just walk straight to it, and I'm pointing you there. You understand? That's my guillotine.